privacy where, you know, most of the children who come from apartments are in the school districts where there are more apartments, right? You don't see many apartments in the Spring Garden area. You see more of the apartments in the Washington area. 32% of the total students, 350, is in the Antioch School, which is due to Cambridge, which is directly due to Cambridge Heights, right? And then the other balance, about 24.5% each, is the high school, you know, where everybody goes to, and Washington. You know, so the rest of the numbers are de minimis. You know, they don't even move the needle.
Yeah, so here's the challenge.
Yeah.
We do know, and here's been one of the concerns that we've had. We know that there was a reduction of about 360 children that were identified 12 years ago in that one-family house sector that had been slowly coming down. At the same time, the multifamily has been rising. So although the areas like Spring Garden, parts of Yamacore and Radcliffe that are primarily one-family homes, the challenge that we have is that we are capacity at all of the schools, whether we're using variances or not. And when those one-family homes begin to produce children, the question that still remains is what happens when they go into those areas that do have those one-family homes that we've identified and going into buildings that are at capacity. So those are the challenges that this is going to be the next wave of challenge that we have. The reduction in one-family homes has given us that cushion that's been fortified by the multifamily students that are coming in. So that cushion that we would usually have that gives us some breathing room in those buildings.
What's the demographer's curve?
Well, the demographer from a year and a half ago, we had another 500 students coming in. And so far, our enrollment numbers are still increasing for us to get to that number. And I did a rough data search at the time back in December. And just to do a quick search, we were looking at some numbers. And I know data searches are not always 100% accurate, but I just went in there and identified how many children that are in Nutley right now under the age of 5. Mm-hmm. And the number was, the family household was at about 900. So I don't know how that impacts, right? You have a 5-year window there where these kids would eventually come in, whether they're siblings, whether they're the first child coming through the district. But we have some challenges that we're going to have to face, I think, in the next coming years, and we're going to continue to monitor it. And that's the best part about all of us being here is as long as we continue to communicate, we'll be able to understand how those trends are going and make some decisions.
Marcella, you spoke of the demographer's report.
Yeah.
How accurate is the data? I mean, now it's been over 2 years since he issued this report?
About a year and a half.
A year and a half? How accurate are his numbers?
He doesn't give us a number year over year. So when they look at it, and they look at it over a 5-year window. But when we did it the first time, because remember we did it twice over a 3-year period. When we did it the first time, his numbers were within 2 or 3 students of Washington. That's how accurate those numbers
were. Mr. Carcillo, what determines what apartment complexes you're including in this? Like Hancock's Avenue sticks out as a large apartment complex.
Yes. So I'm gonna refer quickly to Mr. Ian.
Over the years, the moderate specifically requested moderate or particular address. As a matter of fact, their report that this policy to that had specific new addresses that they wanted to add to that as well. Most of those are new enough that they didn't have a bunch of ways to do that, but we'll be monitoring those in the future, going forward.